Welcome to DIYTryin.
Catchphrase.
I'm Patrick Norton.
I'm Michael Hand.
And we are going to measure electricity today.
Yes,
literally.
We're gonna figure out how much power your devices are eating up.
Electrical consumption, the wattage they consume. And we're gonna do that by measuring the amperage. And we're gonna do that by tapping into an extension cord or power strip.
Yeah, so there's things on the market, like the kilowatt does a similar thing.
That P3 International, woo!
They're really cool, but this is DIYTryin and we wanna make something.
Yeah, a few weeks ago we told you how to use a multimeter or multi-tester or a volt amp meter or volt ammeter, whatever you wanna call it. That's my beloved Fluke 112 right there. And what you do is you actually tap into the hot wire, the 120 volt AC hot wire. So we're gonna talk a little bit about safety as we go along, so you don't electrocute yourself. Number one, unplug the extension cord before you start cutting into it. it sounds ridiculous, but.
Good thing. So we're gonna be we're gonna put this in series with the rest of it.
With a couple of banana plug jacks tapped into our wire, and we're gonna put, well, basically hot to the multimeter in series and back to your device, and that's gonna give you the exact amperage reading of your device.
And then you'll use the power equation to figure out how many watts it's actually, yes.
What is the power equation?
The power equation is volts times amps equals watts. So we know that we're getting 120 volts.
Right.
So 120 volts times however many amps we're reading, it'll tell us how many watts that device is pulling.
Well, actually, as Dominic Guest pointed out in the YouTube comments, we're measuring apparent power, volts times amps, not the real power, which is volts times amps times the power factor. My kilowatts is a fan, a 1500 watt gaming machine, CF light bulbs all had a PF close to one. A laptop transformer, though, had a PF of 0.65, so our volt times amp calculation would give us nearly twice as much wattage as it actually consumes. So generally speaking, we're overestimated. By the way, we measured voltage in the office. It was anywhere from 110 to 117 volts. Depending on the socket. Might want to measure that before you start doing the math.
It's electricity, whoa.
And then you can take the wattage and figure out the kilowatt hours, which will tell you exactly how much you are being charged or a device is costing you per hour.
Let's do it. Let's build it.
Yes.
All you'll need is a power strip or other source of wire, banana panel mounts, plastic hobby box, and a female outlet connector. Oh, and an amp meter. That's probably important.
So we drilled a hole here, a 3/8 inch, and reamed it out a little bit with the multi-tool and drilled a hole here. And we fed the cable through, and now we're gonna cut the hot wire, which is hopefully the right wire to cut, haha.
It's not plugged in, right?
Tell me.
No.
Good. Remember kids, measure twice, cut once, safety first, and always, always work with electricity with a buddy. And make sure you're not holding on to them when you actually touch the electricity or you'll kill both your asses. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna solder these wires onto these posts. Now, important safety tip, do not touch the posts. Well, you can't, right? That's why we use banana plugs here, another standard Radio Shack part. While our cable is rated for 15 amps, our banana plugs are only rated for 10 amps. So try not to connect the biggest appliance in your house on this. And by the way, if your space heater says it's drawing 15 amps, it's probably drawing 15 amps. And, you know, don't plug anything else into that circuit. This is the part where he burns me and I scream.
Yeah, I shouldn't be doing this.
Well, we're soldering a big piece of copper here.
Here, I'll hold it, because I only trust myself to solder when it only involves myself.
That's probably very thoughtful of you. And when you're cutting or soldering or just working on a project, it's a great time to be listening to Audible Entertainment books. Well, digital books. Digital audiobooks.
Go to audiblepodcast.com/DIY and you'll get a free audiobook of your choice.
They are a sponsor, but we both are big fans of spoken word entertainment, and audiblepodcast.com/DIY is the premier source of spoken word entertainment on the internet. Get a free book, go to audiblepodcast.com/DIY, and, well, you'll be helping support the show and we will be able to bring you more projects in the future.
Next, we'll wire in a female outlet so that we can plug in the devices that we actually want to measure.
Green goes to this one. The green or ground is the bottom hole, neutral is the long slot which gets the white wire, and the short slot is the hot wire or black, and that would be green, white, black. So our completed power monitoring thing.
So what we did to recap is we took a power cable, we split it, we interrupted it with two banana plugs.
Basically the hot runs in one side of this, out of the other, so we put what in series with this?
We put our multimeter in series with whatever the electricity is gonna go
basically
through.
The hot wire off of our alternating current line.
So keep in mind your multimeter does need to do AC amperage.
Yes.
Otherwise bad things might happen.
And if everything works the way it's supposed to, when I plug this into that
well, when I plug these together, the light should come on, and that should read 0.4-ish amps, because 120 volts divided by 50
this
equals
is a 50 watt bulb.
Yeah.
0.4445 amps.
That's pretty good math for an English major as
That's
far as
close.
I'm concerned. So remember that your multimeter is completing this circuit, and if you disconnect your multimeter.
That's safe.
Yeah.
Don't disconnect when it's plugged in. Don't disconnect the multimeter end or else you're, don't do that.
See, if I had this and this and held them, my heart would stop or my eyes would explode. But in any case, do us a favor, practice safety. Disconnect.
Unplug from that side.
The power source and put it somewhere else before you disassemble your little test rig. This is DIYTryin, our weekly show where we attempt to make something cool.
And we did. We succeeded.
Please comment down below. At least we like it. If you don't, comment down below. Tell us we suck or email DIYTryin@reason3.com.
Hey, thanks for watching.
I'm Bobby Norton.
I'm Michael Land.
We'll see you next week on DIYTryin.
See ya. I couldn't.
This one's for the ladies.
I couldn't stick my tongue in both holes at the same time.
Today is brought to you by double entendres and the letter Q.